this is the presentation of Deformable Graph Convolutional Networks. Graph neural networks have been widely applied to various domains such as social network analysis, recommendation systems, chemistry, and so on. Most existing graph neural networks have shown superior performance on various graph-related tasks by performing message passing frameworks which iteratively learn node representations via aggregating messages from local neighborhoods. Despite their success, graph convolution in most GNNs has two limitations. First, its difficulty in capturing long-range dependencies. The second is performance degradation on heterophilic graphs. Most graph convolution learns node representations by recursively aggregating their local neighborhood features. So, to capture long-range dependencies, it is necessary to construct deep GNNs by stacking more layers. However, Li et al. Found that node representations generated by GCNs become indistinguishable as graph convolutional layers are deeper, which is called the oversmoothing issue. To experimentally verify the oversmoothing issue, Li et al. Applied GCNs with a different number of layers. This figure illustrates node representations generated by one-layer GCNs on Jacquard's Karate Club dataset. Next illustrates representations generated by two-layer GCNs and 3, 4, 5. As you can see, node representation becomes indistinguishable as layers are deeper. This indicates that stacking a deeper graph convolutional layer leads to oversmoothing issues, and graph convolutional networks have a difficulty in capturing long-range dependencies. The second limitation of most existing graph neural networks is performance degradation on heterophilic graphs. Before discussing performance degradation on heterophilic graphs, we briefly introduce homophilic graphs and heterophilic graphs. Homophilic graphs are graphs with a homophilic property. The homophilic property is a key principle of many real-world graphs, whereby linked nodes often belong to the same class or have similar features. For example, papers are more likely to cite papers from similar research subjects. On the other side, heterophilic graphs are graphs where linked nodes are likely from different classes or features. Since most graph neural networks implicitly assume that input graphs are homophilic graphs, they often underperform on heterophilic graphs. In particular, a simple multilayer perceptron, which ignores the topological properties of graphs, shows better performance. From the experimental research on Zhu et al., MLP outperforms most existing graph neural networks on graphs with a low homophily ratio, which indicates the degree of homophily. To address these two limitations of graph neural networks, we propose deformable graph convolutional networks that perform deformable convolution on multiple latent graphs. Since our deformable graph convolution can be derived from the general definition of the discrete convolution by a kernel with finite support, we first revisit the general definition of the discrete convolution. The convolution of a feature map H by a kernel G at a point B is given as follows. For example, in a 2D convolution with a 3x3 convolution kernel, given image feature map which corresponds to H and a pixel V marked with a yellow point, the function G is a linear function to transform features in 3x3 neighborhoods from pixel V. Therefore, for each relative position, a linear function is applied. in the image domain, it is easy to calculate relative position since the image has its explicit position with coordinates. However, nodes in the graph do not have their explicit positions. So, reversing bad nodes in a position space, which is a latent space, to determine the coordinates of nodes using a node positioner embedding. Even it is possible that our frameworks can use various node embedding methods such as line, nodeback, distance encoding, Poincaré embedding in hyperbolic geometry, and other various node embedding methods, we apply our proposed node positioner embeddings. Our node positioner embedding is computed by a simple procedure as follows. Given a node, node positioner embedding is projected input features after submitting L times on the input graph G. Based on the node positioner embedding of each node, we obtain the relation between nodes, which is represented by a relation vector R. In a 2D convolution, the relation can be defined as relative position on a position space B. Similarly, we use normalized relation vectors to encode the relation between nodes in our framework. Our kernel function G is defined as follows. The function value of G, which is a linear transformation, varies depending on the relation vector. V is a kernel vector, and WK is a corresponding transformation matrix. Our kernel function has an interesting difference from 2D convolution. Since the standard 2D convolution kernel has a linear transformation matrix for each relative position, the number of its transformation matrices increases as the kernel size increases, whereas our kernel G differentially combines a fixed number of weight matrices depending on the relation vector. So, the number of weight matrices of our convolution does not depend on the kernel size anymore. To further extend the kernel function, we define the deformable graph convolution based on above convolution kernel. We first dynamically translate kernel vectors tilde phi using deformation vector delta k depending on the node B. Then we define our deformable graph convolution as follows. We use softmax operation for calculating a hat, and we found that the dot product attention can be viewed as a variant of convolution. For more details, please see our supplementary materials. Deformable graph convolution is computed within a neighborhood tilde n. To compute the neighborhood n, we use k nearest neighborhood graphs. We generate multiple latent neighborhood graphs with L number of submitted input features to determine the neighborhood N. Based on multiple latent neighborhood graphs, we design deformable graph convolutional networks to adaptively aggregate outputs of convolutions on multiple latent neighborhood graphs with attention mechanisms. To learn more effective deformable graph convolution without collapsed kernel vectors, we impose two regularizers. First is the separating regularizer. The separating regularizer maximizes the distance between kernel vectors so that our kernel differentially yields transformation matrices against diverse relations. Second is the focusing regularizer. The focusing regularizers penalize the L2 norm of deformation vectors to avoid extreme changes of the deformable kernel and the collapse of kernel vectors after deformations. With these two regularizers, we use the standard cross-entropy loss function for node classification tasks. So, the total loss function is as follows. To validate the effectiveness of our proposed deformable graph convolutional networks, we conduct experiments on 9 datasets, which are composed of 6 heterophilic graphs and 3 homophilic graphs. The best model for each dataset is highlighted with bold face. Overall, our deformable GCN achieves the highest performance on all heterophilic graphs compared to all baselines. Interestingly, on some heterophilic graphs such as Texas, Wisconsin, Act 2, and Kono, MLP outperforms various GNNs such as GCN, GAD, and GMGCN without utilizing any graph structure information. On homophilic graphs, deformable GCN shows comparable performance compared to other baselines. Since most existing GNNs have been proposed based on the homophilic assumption, the performance gap between the GNN-based model and our model is small. We conduct additional experiments to verify the contribution of components of our deformable graph convolutional networks. To verify the efficacy of our node positional embedding method, we compare it with other node embedding methods, such as Node2Vec and Poincaré embedding, by using them for node positional embedding on 4 datasets. Our method outperforms 2 other embedding methods for all datasets. Unlike other methods that require separate pre-training, our positional embedding can be simultaneously trained with GNNs in an end-to-end fashion. We believe that our embedding scheme is much easier to train and allows more optimized positional embeddings for downstream tasks. To examine the contribution of the deformable graph convolution layer, we experiment by substituting it with the GAT layer on 4 datasets. From the table, deformable GCOMP consistently shows better performance compared to GAT layer, which means that deformable GCOMP contributes to the performance improvements of deformable GCN. To reveal the effectiveness of deformation, we compare the results of deformable GCN and the model without deformation according to the number of kernel vectors. The figure shows that deformable GCNs consistently achieve superior performance than the models without deformation in various settings. Also, for qualitatively analyzing the effectiveness of deformation, we visualize the kernel vectors and deformation in the position space. To study the efficacy of the deformation, we calculate the homophilic weight based on A. We compare H weight before or after deformation. After deformation, the kernel vectors tend to be occluded to the neighbor nodes with the same labels, which are black solid circles. As a result, H weight becomes larger values and deformable GCN receives more messages from meaningful neighborhoods. To verify the contribution of regularizers, separating regularizer and focusing regularizer, we qualitatively analyze the effectiveness of regularizers with visualizations of kernel vectors and deformations. The green square denotes the kernel vectors before deformation, and the purple square denotes kernel vectors after deformation. Without separating regularizers, we can observe that kernel vectors before deformation are often collapsed. Similarly, without focusing regularizers, we can observe that kernel vectors after deformation are often collapsed, which is problematic since the collapsed kernel vectors makes the transformation matrices similar across kernels. On the other side, with both regularizers, kernel vectors before and after deformation is properly positioned so that our kernel differential yields transformation matrices against diverse relations. We also quantitatively analyzed regularizers with an ablation study on regularizers. From the table, each regularizer contributes to improving the performance of deformable GCN, and training with both regularizer is most effective. We additionally observed that the attention score as can be used to understand graph datasets. The attention score of its latent neighborhood graphs indicates the overimportance of a latent neighborhood graph. On most heterophilic graphs, except for chameleon and squall, deformable GCN has the large attention score for latent graph G0 and relatively small attention scores for G input. This indicates that rather than focusing on the neighborhood of input graph, the neighborhood of latent graph generated by input features is more helpful for predictions on heterophilic graphs. On the other hand, on the homophilic graphs, input graph G input plays a more important role on homophilic graphs compared to heterophilic graphs. In conclusion, we design a deformable graph convolution that adaptively deforms the convolution kernels to handle heterophily and variable range dependencies between nodes. We propose deformable graph convolutional networks that simultaneously learn node representations and node positional embeddings and perform deformable GCOMP in multiple latent spaces. We empirically show that deformable GCNs are effective for learning representations on both heterophilic and homophilic graphs. Future works applying our networks to other tasks such as graph classification and link predictions, and expanding deformable GCOMP to other domains. Thank you for watching my presentations. Thank you.